Do you want to know how to convert your colors to Pantone? Or how to save custom color swatches in Adobe Illustrator? I will show you how in this Adobe Illustrator guide to Pantone colors and swatches. What is up, people? I'm back again with another graphic design tips video. I quickly want to thank all of my subscribers because my channel is experiencing the fastest growth it ever has. So I really appreciate all of the positive feedback. Today we are looking at two areas of Adobe Illustrator relating to the use of color. Yasser Arafat commented on my last video with a suggestion, and so today I've decided to make a video based around his suggestion. If you do have any queries or ideas, then go ahead and let me know in the comment section below. You could end up with your very own video just like Mr. Arafat has today. First, we'll be looking at Pantone Color and how to open the Pantone Swatch Library. From there, I will show you how to convert a design that is not Pantone into a Pantone color scheme. And then finally, how to create and save custom swatches in Adobe Illustrator, which will enable you to have specific colors at the ready whenever you need them. Pantone colors are used by printers to make sure that you get an exactly accurate color mix of your printed design. Each Pantone color has its own number ID, and they are universally recognized in the design industry. So for example, if you are designing a logo, you want all of the colors to print out the same wherever they are printed around the world. Hence why a Pantone would be given by the designer. To add a Pantone swatch, we want to go to Window, Swatch Libraries, Color Books. And when you have accessed that, find Pantone Solid Uncoated or Coated, depending on your design. As you can see, if you hover your cursor over each color, you have the ID appear. That's great, but what if you have made a design that is not Pantone and you want to convert it to Pantone colors? Here you can see some circles of color that make up my design. These are not Pantone colors at the moment, they are CMYK, but we can easily change that in Adobe Illustrator. Let's first duplicate these color circles. From here, select a color and then go up to Edit, Edit Colors, and Recolor Artwork. Then click this icon here, and click on Color Books, and then again I would suggest Pantone Solid Uncoated or Coated. Now you can see the color is now a Pantone swatch. You must remember, however, that Adobe Illustrator will match your original color to the nearest possible Pantone in the library. This is why you need to remember to do your work in Pantone prior to making the finished design. Repeat the process for each color and you will have converted your whole artwork to Pantone. Finally, we're going to look at how to save custom swatches in Adobe Illustrator. This is useful if you have a set of colors used in a design that you want to access easily at a later stage. So you have the design here and you want to save these swatches. In a swatch window, click the icon in the top right corner and head down to Save Swatch Library as AI. The option above allows for swatches to be opened in any Adobe program, but for this we're just going to use AI. You can save the swatches here, right into Adobe Directory. So let's see in this new document how to access them. In the swatches window, click on the top right icon again, and then open Swatch Libraries. Then go down to User Defined, and My Custom Swatches, and voila, there you have it. A Pantone Color and Swatches Adobe Illustrator Guide. I hope you have found this tutorial helpful. If you did, then let me know in the comment section below and smash that like button. I upload tutorials every Tuesday, speed up videos every single Thursday, and a bonus video on Sunday. Subscribe to stay updated to all of my uploads, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.